Hello, my name is Kendra Winchester, and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a book haul for you of the books that I have received from publishers. So thanks to all of them for sending me these copies of these books. Now, in all fairness, I have not read these books, so I don't know entirely what they are about, and I don't really want to know because I don't want to spoil it for myself, but I will link all of them down below so you can go check them out if it sounds like something that you're interested in. And so I'll try to let you know why I want to read each one and different things like that. But again, I don't want to have any spoilers. So if you know something about the book, please do not tell me anything so I can, you know, experience the joy of a plot twist. Okay, let's just start with the most recently received because they're on top of this pile here. Okay, so first up we have from Tin House, The Magical Language of Others by E.J. Coe. And this is a book that is a memoir, and it like looks at language and I think at translation. So Matthew and Jacqueline, BookTube buddies of mine, really love this book. And so when it arrived in the mail, I was like, hey, I think I saw one of you posting about this. Did you like it? And so they said, yes. They did. So I am waiting to get this on audio. It's actually an Audible only title, so waiting a little bit on that, but I'm so excited. And it's a gorgeous cover. Tin House is just doing such a great job. Speaking of Tin House, I saw Allison Reads DC over on Instagram reading this book, and I was like, I need this. I need this book in my life. And this is Things We Didn't Talk About When I Was a Girl by Jeannie Venasco. So this is a book that I've also seen Liberty Hardy talking about, and this is a story of Jeannie's experience in high school when one of her best friends rapes her, and like what she does after that, and the complications of when you have a close relationship with the person who has sexually assaulted you. And so obviously trigger warnings for this book, but I've heard nothing but good things about this book, and I have no earthly idea why I have yet to read it. It is high up on my TBR. It's also sitting there waiting for my credits to renew in Audible so I can go pick it up, because again, I've heard nothing but amazing things about this book. This is I think a queer love story from what I can tell. This is from Chronicle Books. This is Redwood and Ponytail by K.A. Holt. And this is told in a poetry novel form, but one side is one character's and perspective, and one side is often another character's perspective. Let me see if I can find it. Some of them aren't side by side, but some of them are. And so I found this really interesting that this is a love story told in a poetry novel kind of format, but it's also from two different perspectives. And so it sounded amazing. And so when they asked if I wanted a copy, I was like, yes, please. And this also is a brilliant addition. Chronicle Books does an amazing job with their titles. And so you also can see these gorgeous end papers. So Chronicle Books knows how to make a book. So the next book I have is one I've seen everywhere, and this is Miranda Popke's Topics of Conversation. This is supposed to be for people who like Conversations with Friends by Sally Rooney. I've heard that it's not quite as good as Sally Rooney, but I'm not quite sure. But again, good job to Knopf for like creating this adorable, tiny book. And I hope that I enjoy it as much as the people raving about it on the internet. But we'll see. I've heard good things. At least it's thought-provoking, I think, is gonna be the minimum, I think, for this. Hopefully. I struggle because I get my hopes up, and then my hopes are dashed sometimes, and I just don't want that to be the case. Speaking of afraid of having your hopes dashed, Tightrope. Americans Reaching for Hope by Nicholas D. Kristof and Cheryl Wu Dunn. This is the husband-wife team that wrote Half the Sky, which is about women in different countries and the difficulties that they face. And I listened to an interview with this pair of authors on the New York Times Book Review podcast, and they were talking about how they used to think that places in other countries, there were such difficult things that there's no way that anyone in America could ever be experiencing those difficult things. And then they went and looked a little closer at their own home country and realized that there were places where women experience a large degree of difficulty, but not just women, the communities themselves. And so they went and looking at a lot of communities in this, I think, working class, more so town, and what that looks like. I have not read the book yet, but it was featured so heavily on the Here Comes Book Review podcast. I was like, I'm not sure what I'm getting myself into. I hope I like it, but I don't know. As someone who does come from one of those communities, predominantly working class, isolated, rural-ish communities, I am always hesitant, as you may have gathered. I hope it's good. I hope for their sakes it's good. We'll see. There's also supposed to be a documentary, which I'm excited about. I don't know about you, but yeah, that's tightrope. So this book was sent to me from the UK. I think it's coming out in the US as well. This is Why Women Read Fiction, The Stories of Our Lives by Helen Taylor. And this is just, you know, about women and reading, and that seemed right up my alley. So thanks so much to Oxford University Press for sending me this book. A book I don't know too much about, but am also very much looking forward to, and have had several people send me screenshots of the cover of this book, is Hill Women by Cassie Chambers. And this is about Hill Women. The subtitle says, Finding Family and a Way Forward in the Appalachian Mountains. What else do you need to know? So thanks so much to Valentine for this one. I am hoping it does well. Again, very concerned with people write about Appalachia. I hope it works out. So this one is a short story collection out from Bloomsbury, and this is Show Them a Good Time. And it says at the top of the blurb here, a blistering, original, and wickedly funny collection of stories about the strange worlds that women inhabit and the parts that they must play. I'm always interested in women's roles in society, and so this definitely looks like a short story collection that's up my alley. And that cover, it's like one of those like illustrations or paintings you just can't stop staring at. There's just so much happening on this. Okay, so this one is about a young woman from Northern England and her experience there, and then moving to London and what it's like to be from the North, I believe, moving to the South, to London. So this is Saltwater by Jessica Andrews. I haven't heard too many things about it, but after having that conversation with Sarah Moss, I've definitely been more interested in reading from Northern England, since it is somewhat equivalent to the American South that we have. And so we'll see what happens with it. FSG, which publishes this book here in the US, does a great job with their titles. So I'm very excited for this one as well. So this is Little Gods by Meng Jin, and this is from Custom House. And this is about a daughter who is the daughter of a Chinese immigrant. And so she's born in the United States, and then after her mother dies, she goes back, I believe, to China to try to figure out the stories of her mother's past, I believe is how the story goes. I'm very interested to see how this story plays out, because I'm really into family secrets and trying to understand where you came from, especially when you have a child of immigrants trying to figure out what's going on with their family back to where the country that their parents came from. So that's always interesting to me. And I've seen this all over Instagram. I mean, obviously it's gorgeous, but I'm hoping this story is equally captivating. Another book I've seen everywhere is a book from Graydon House, and this is Followers, a novel by Megan Angelo, and this is about two girls. One of them is a wannabe A-lister, and then it also looks at a timeline in the future from that, and like the secrets that this one character is having. And so it's supposed to be a story of women and intrigue and the desire for fame and fortune, and whether or not that pans out. So I wouldn't typically put this on my list, but I've seen so many people review it in such interesting ways. I kind of want to see what it's like for myself. So I also find the cover really interesting, and it really does focus on women's lives. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm trying to remain positive and optimistic. So those are the books from my stacks that I am very excited about. I hope that you also have checked them out. If you have read them and you have any tips for me, let me know. What one should I read first? What one did you really like? To tell me all of the things. Really, your comments help me decide like what I'm going to invest my time in. What book am I going to pick up next? And I always find that so helpful. So thank you so much. And until next time, I'll talk to you later. Bye, guys.